Good afternoon and welcome to completing a study submission for a new study using the ICT. So the first thing we do is we go into the submissions page and click submission for a new study. You can see below other studies that have already been created using this user. We go to the page here, click agree and proceed to agree to the above disclosure. And then we press to proceed to submission. And this page is where you put the initial data in relation to the study's name, title, protocol, reference, and IRAS number. So for the sake of simplicity, we're going to make up a new study, entering the correct IRAS number for the study. There we've created the initial details for the study. Again, within this page, you would normally insert the correct details of the study in question and the sponsor. What we're going to do here is just insert some simple details. That's not actually my telephone number. I'm not sure if you ring it. And also, that is not the email address of my cat, funnily enough. Rest of these details you can leave blank because they're not mandatory. This is the services page, and in order to click the service we require, it's 20D, which is a study resource review. The indication of this is we would like to enter a study resource required to complete the activities listed in a protocol schedule of events and then obtain feedback on whether these have been captured appropriately in the interactive costing tool. Service is required prior to HRA approval. If we click it there, we also need to state that it is not a resubmission. In this case, it's not a medical devices study, and we're also going to say that it hasn't been submitted to the HRA already. And back to the top of the page, just say here that the study is allocated to the UK. Just enables us to be able to move through to the next page. Obviously, all those things wouldn't necessarily be appropriate for your study. And the next page asks for study info, so these. So not applicable to the bottom two questions. For example, we won't be using a drug. We're also going to say the study is not multinational and it's not a biosimilar study. Again, those may, your answers to those questions may be different depending on your study that you are submitting. Then we find ourselves at the study resources tab. This is really the meat and potatoes of what we're doing as a training session. So I'll take you through these things. So initially, had the study resources study already been agreed by an NHS organisation, we're going to say no there because we're making a first-time submission. And we're also going to say, the question says, has the study protocol been attached? We're going to assume, for the sake of this quick tutorial, that a study protocol has been attached through the attachments tab, which is here at the top of the page. So we click to add an arm. First thing it does is ask us for a name. You have to name your arms, even if you just name and this is what it gives you. Presented with three individual tables, which cover the scheduled activities that will happen for all participants, scheduled activities that will happen for some participants, and unscheduled activities, also known as additional itemised costs, which may happen ad hoc during the study. From here, very simply, you need to consider the number of visits that your protocol has. We're going to say 8, which means you can delete 9 and 10 from the sheet. You'll notice that as it deletes here, it also deletes in the scheduled section here. And we can start adding some activities. So we have a list, we have an opportunity of either picking a procedure or an investigation. We're going to say procedure, and within the box here you can free text type and it will look up within the field below to see if you can find something that matches what you're typing. So we put in the word consent. You can see that it gives you two options. This consent for a genetic sample, the second is an informed consent. In this case we're going to be picking an informed consent. You'll also see, having picked that, it then auto-populates the details at the right-hand end. If these figures and members of staff are appropriate for that activity, click confirm and move on. If, however, you feel that they're not appropriate for the activity on a given study, you can change the staff roles simply by clicking a drop-down and selecting other members of staff, or alternatively, members of staff are correct, but the timings aren't necessarily what's required. These can also be altered. It's worth noting at this point that if you do alter away from the national values, then you will be asked for a comment. In this case, I'm just going to click confirm. Now you can see that informed consent has been added as an activity within the row. The next thing to do is to add where the informed consent takes place. We're going to say informed consent occurs at the first visit. So we click the plus symbol, which gives us a 1. You'll also see that it's giving you a net cost at the right hand end. This is based upon the time that you accepted within the individual visit, so within here. So I'm going to go on and add a few more activities within the given study, just so that we've got a bit of a framework to work with. At this point, I'm going to add two different types of activity to the original procedures that I've added above. The first thing I'm going to add is an investigation. As you may have noticed, I've added taking of a blood test and the completion of that blood test within a lab. So we're going to click onto investigation rather than procedure. The words blood count in. See, within pathology, blood count comes out at the top of the list. So again, we collect it and add it to the list. The second type of activity I'm going to add here is a telephone call. Now, if I'm to initially put in telephone call, you will see it tells me there's no results found. This is not the end of the line. Basically, what you can do in such a situation is you can click on the button above that says enter manually, and it will give you a free text field. And then select the department that we're making the telephone call, in this case the study team, and assign a staff role against it for the individual who will be carrying out the telephone call, let's say 20 minutes. And let's go back and complete some of the individual occurrences. We can also change the details at the top of the page for actual visit names. So instead of visit 8, we'll call this one follow-up. You can then complete when subject questionnaires occur. Let's say a visit 2, a visit 3, a visit 4, visit 5, visit 6, and visit 7. With a reviewer questionnaire after the patient has left the clinic on the same days. Ensuring that we match the blood count along with the blood sample collection, we can place in the rows there. Another way of being able to ensure that you can match it against individual collections, you can use the arrow keys here, which will enable us to move the blood count up to being the row below blood sampling, which hopefully will mean that you can match it exactly to the visit as it occurs. And then let's place our telephone follow-up in the last visit, just there. So where do the other tables come into use? So first thing, some occurrences may occur within a protocol on given days, but may not be happening for every single patient. For example, pregnancy tests for female patients recruited onto the study. Let's make the assumption that within this protocol, both men and women are going to be recruited, and that a pregnancy test will be carried out on the same days when a blood draw is made. First, third, fifth and seventh visit. So we go in and and we select investigation because you're looking for a serum log, a serum pregnancy test. Collect that and we confirm. And because we know it's happening when the blood tests are happening, we can click it. That visit, that visit, that visit, that visit. One other thing that the system does allow you to do is, should this study be solely for recruiting women, is that if you've already entered it in this box, you need to move it up to this box so that every single patient will be receiving a pregnancy test. You can do that, and you can do it after the fact simply by clicking on the individual procedure and clicking on the drop down at the top that states some participants, and you can move it to the all participants section. See, it's left this box now, and it now appears in the top of the top box. However, we're not going to do this for the sake of example. We're going to move it back to the some participants box. The third box we have is for unscheduled activities. If you use the old industry costing template, Excel workbook, you'll know that there was an individual sheet for these. They are simply the individual procedures or investigations that occur or may occur or may not occur for individual patients, but need to be captured within the overall contract so that those activities can be reimbursed should they occur within the course of the protocol. So what we're going to put in here, we're going to put in a second telephone follow-up. So go to procedure. We know the telephone follow-up isn't within the activity list, so we're going to have to click enter manually. Or study team, add the staff role. And as you'll see, the individual value for that telephone call matches the value that's in the one follow-up at the top. This will enable there to be additional follow-ups beyond the one that's within the written protocol and ensures that that activity is therefore covered. The other thing you're able to do within this individual sheet is not just look at what's happening in terms of the visits, but the visits against the activities and the occurrences on given days. You can actually look at the activity details. This gives you a basic breakdown of the information that's contained within each of these sheets without having to click in and out of the screen. It provides the procedure, department carrying out that procedure. So for example, the study team carrying out physical procedures and pathology department carrying out the blood test. Activity code, which either relates to an NIHR price code or alternatively, in the case of the investigation here, relates directly to the grant plan coding used by industry. It gives you an indication of the individual member of staff who is carrying out a procedure and the time it takes for those individual members of staff and a value. It also gives you a rough activity count at the right hand end. At this point, we've effectively completed our entire schedule of events. And if that's the end of our protocol, then we can move towards submitting it for review. So we click the next page. The work that we've carried out has been saved. It takes us to the trial management screen. Again, we're going to put in some simple data using today's date, the times completed. And then we're going to click next, which will move us through to the last screen, which is the confirmation. At that point, we're going to click submit and the study goes through to the submissions queue where it appears on the top line as created. We can check what the status is, pending validation, with the study resource review pending validation, which means that we, as a company representative, have now submitted that study. The next point will be for the individual feasibility team member to assign that study to a validator. And that's the end of the signing session. I hope it's been useful. Thank you.